Thank you very much, Mr. Master of Ceremonies, and a good friend for many years standing. In fact, I sat with him at the UV distance education in Bastia, St. Kitts, as we pursued a number of subjects in the UV program then. And we sat together in one of the subjects we took together was indeed politics. He never imagined that I would have become a politician. And I never imagined he would be so close to politicians. So it is a good feeling to be here. And I want to thank the Honourable Premier Mark Brantley for allowing me the opportunity to say a few words. I won't be long, but for me, as the Prime Minister of the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis, and the leader of a Team Unity administration, it is a distinct pleasure and joy to know that you, the people of Nevis, when it mattered most, sent a clear message that yes, performance matters, but people matter more. So congratulations to all the people of Nevis. And I am sure my father, who hails from Cotton Ground, would be very pleased that this day has come. I congratulate you because democracy requires the full involvement of the citizens. Democracy requires that you stay attuned and you stay focused. Because don't let them fool you. Governing is hard work. Opposing is easy work. I want to thank you because there are times when you are governing, you hear a lot of voices, and it becomes critically important to be able to discern what is the real truth out there. And the people of Nevis sent a clear message where the country stands at this time of the year. And it was a beautiful message that ricochets in St. Kitts and ricochets all over the world, that the unity, call it what you will, the unity creation of the people is stronger than ever going forward. And that is why, in spite of the fact that I was feeling a slight pain, in fact a very difficult pain, I said nothing will stop me from coming to Nevis and put on a suit of blue. So I say thank you. I have come because really, you have shown the world that the people well informed can distinguish between noise and substance. And just as you have done, we will do in 2020, distinguish again noise from substance. Congratulations for choosing substance. Congratulations from the bottom of my heart for creating stability, because stability is critical for the ongoing trust and development, not just of Nevis, but of St. Christopher and Nevis. Thank you. You had a choice and you chose wisely. You gave the NIA administration to the able and astute hands of the Honourable Mark Bentley as a new premier. And as the Prime Minister of the Federal Cabinet, I have seen the Honourable Mark Bentley at work. You know how smart he is, how courageous he is, and that he is a sheriff in Charlestown and elsewhere. So I am not going to tell you too much about that, because you had all the facts and statistics to back up that when you voted. I would say it is a delight to be able to work with another Nevis Island administration that will put the people of Nevis first. It is a delight for us at the federal level to welcome the CCM back again and to welcome the Honourable Mark Bentley in the elevated position that you, the people, have bestowed on him as the Honourable Premier of the island of Nevis. So congratulations, Honourable Premier. Congratulations to the Deputy Premier. Congratulations to all the other Honourable Ministers. Thank you very much for being part of this victory. And really, you have given us another joy at Christmas. So thanks for this Christmas gift. I want to pledge that the unity movement had always been about going forward. It had always been about creating history. Not any old history that harkens to the past. It was a history that we must create every day by our actions, by our deed, by our courage, by our sense of purpose and justice. That's what brought the unity together. That is what the leaders of the CCM had when they determined to break the tradition of division between federal and NIA, when they determined that they will sign on an accord that was watershed in the history of politics, providing an opportunity for genuine unity, cooperation, amicability in the relationship, ease of dialogue, no more bouncing of the threat of the NIA, but a genuine partnership. And all of us open our eyes at least once to that reality. I say to those in the leadership of Team Unity, never once close your eyes to the history that we have created. It will not always be easy, because nothing in life ever will. Nothing worth fighting for ever will come easy. That is why you have to have courage. That is why you have to have a sense of justice. So even when you are down, the justice within you say, I shall rise again. And so thank you to Premier Amy, who led and was leader then of CCM, when he enjoined in the Team Unity movement. And what I would say of him is that he is a man whose word is his bond. And every commitment that he gave to me privately has worked publicly. He has been a rich and powerful resource on which I have relied. And the stability in part of the Team Unity is due in no small measure to the maturity of the Honourable Vance Amy. So thank you, my brother, and thank you, my friend. I say thank you, of course, to the new premier. A wonderful addition to the leadership of the CCM, and of course, we have had the blessings of his work. And Mark, of course, will always have a special place in my memory, in my heart, and in the history of the Team Unity. because several nights he braved stormy waters. Not content to be sheriff of Charleston, but to ensure good governance and decency at the federal level. And he came and made brave in Bastille and in St. Kitts, banning the flame of unity. And I say thank you. My heart is a heart of gratitude. I have been active in politics almost for too long. Almost. And so it was easy for me to buy in to the notion, two terms and vote. Two terms and other opportunities for service. So I am looking forward for 2025 or somewhere there when I shall withdraw so that others may move forward. The legacy of the first 10 years of Team Unity must be in the alleyways and the byways which created something almost magical called unity. We broke the warmongering in the politics. We made it possible for the politician who needs to feel comfortable in St. Kitts and vice versa. We bridge the political divide. Yes, the politics may always be robust and tough, for the harder they come, the harder they are to fall. That's the reality. So we welcome that in the spirit of democracy. But we must create bonds and go beyond the party divide. Sometimes we get caught up going back to the past for which we have become accustomed. In the past, the politics was simply about winner takes it all. Labour Party, Labour take it all. CCM Party, CCM take it all. NRP Party, Party determine it all. But we have moved away to that. We have moved away from that to say we must build a broader circle and space for all to feel a part of nation building. And I am sure that this seasoned cabinet of champions of the people will open their arms, will open their ears to ideas that are good for the advancement of leaders. And I pledge, as the Prime Minister, to always be, whenever there is a need, for us to be there, and we shall always be there anywhere, but we shall be there to assist the Nevis Island Administration in advancing the best interests of the people of St. Kitts and Nevis. And at the end of the day, the legacy will not just be about unity, and we will talk about that another time. It must be that we created stability. It must be that we built on the foundations of democracy. It must be that we leave the economy strong. And it must be that fiscal prudence was the hallmark of what we did in government. So from the bottom of my heart, the son of a strong, magnificent man, Godfrey Nisbet of Cotton Gulf, I come to tell you, and the son of a shy woman from Tabernacle, my mother didn't know anything else but vote. She was no politician, neither am I. I just happened to be a citizen with a strong political view. But I want to say thank you very much to the people of Nevis. Thank you very much. May God bless Nevis. And may God bless our beautiful federation. To God be the glory. Thank you.